video, I'm going to cover opening an existing project and the toolbar functionality in Leapfrog. I'll start by opening a project in the Projects tab. There are a couple of options available for opening an existing project. You can either click Open Project File and search for an existing project, or you can simply click the thumbnail of the project you would like to open. When you open a project in Leapfrog, you will quickly notice the clean user interface with the lack of abundant toolbars and menu options. As discussed in previous sessions, this is the result of the majority of Leapfrog's functionality existing within the appropriate folder. By right-clicking folders in the project tree, you'll see what actions are available to you for that particular object. Because of this workflow-oriented organization, Leapfrog has limited need for toolbars. However, there are very useful tools available in Leapfrog's minimalist toolbar. To start this tutorial, I'm going to view the geology table and one of the output volumes from my geological model. You'll notice that when an object is brought into the scene window, it also appears in the scene list below. You will notice also that the object is shown as bold in the project tree. This lets you keep track of what you're viewing in the scene. Now that we have a couple of objects loaded, let's take a look at the toolbar menu. If you hover your cursor over an icon in the toolbar menu, it will tell you the tool's function. Let's start at the right and take a look at the ruler. To use the ruler, click on the icon and then click and drag from one object to another. You will need to be clicking on an object rather than a point in space, as Leapfrog won't know where in 3D space you're looking. You'll know that you're clicking on an object because you'll notice that coordinates will show up here at the bottom of the screen. When you're hovering over a blank space, no coordinates are shown. Once the distance has been measured, it shows up in the boxes at the ends of the ruler. It also shows up here in the scene list, and you get further information still over here in the Properties panel. In the Properties panel, the XYZ coordinates of the start and end are displayed, as well as the differences between them all. Only one distance can be shown at once, so if I measure a new distance, the previous one will be removed. When you're done measuring, you can right-click once in the scene window, or you can click this select icon in the toolbar to get your regular cursor back. To clear the ruler from the scene, simply click the X in the scene list. The next tool available is to draw a plane line. To draw a new plane, click the icon with the green stripe, and then click and drag the plane in any orientation. Once the plane is drawn, you can click on the plane and the toggles will become available. The plane can be controlled either by these toggles or by adjusting the information available in the Properties panel. We'll look at how planes can be used for modeling in a different tutorial. You'll notice up in the toolbar that there is another tool that looks like a plane, but this one without the green line. This tool can be used to toggle an existing plane on and off. The most frequently used tool in the toolbar is the slicer tool. The slicer tool allows you to have a section view of your data. Just like the draw plane line tool, you use the slicer with the green stripe to draw a new slice. A slice can be drawn in any orientation. For a vertical section view, click the D key on the keyboard prior to drawing the slice. Click the slicer tool and then click and drag to create a new slice. You can change the appearance of the slicer using the controls here in the scene list and the ones within the Properties panel. I will review the basic slicer functionality, but for a comprehensive overview of the slicer tool, please see the video in the Tips and Tricks section. Once you have drawn the slice, you can look directly at it by clicking the L key on the keyboard. You can look at the other side by clicking Shift L. There are two ways that you can move through the slices in the scene. The first way allows you to move the designated step size, and that is by using the comma and the period keys on the keyboard. The comma will move you the step size in one direction, and the period key will move you the designated step size in the other direction. You can also move the slicer smoothly through the scene by holding the control key on the keyboard and clicking and holding down the right mouse button. And then as you move your mouse up and down, you will see the slice move smoothly through your scene. In the properties panel, you can define your slice width, your step size, the dip of the slice, which is 90 degrees in this case because we clicked the D key before drawing the slice, as well as the azimuth. In Leapfrog, if you would like to step such that you do not overlap the sections, but also do not miss any data, ensure to set the slice width and the step size to be the same. Once you are done using the slicer, you can toggle it off using the slicer tool without the green stripe. You can use it again to toggle back on the slice you last saw. The next tool available in the toolbar allows you to swap between the slicer and the plane. Next, we have the look dropdown. This is a list of commonly used shortcut keys. You may notice that I have one additional tool in my toolbar than you might have in yours, and that's the one furthest to the left, which is Save Current Scene. This tool can be displayed in the toolbar by going to the green Leapfrog Geo dropdown and selecting Settings, and then selecting User Interface. This option here allows you to display the Show Saved Scene tool in the toolbar. The Save Scene tool allows you to save the current scene in the scene view. You can give your scene a name as well as a description, click OK, and it will appear in the Saved Scenes and Movies folder so that you can drag that scene out again in case you ever need to view it. Lastly, we have the Clear the Scene button. This button will remove all the objects loaded in the scene. Of course, these objects still exist in the project tree and can be viewed again at any time.